Hello, everyone. First of all, thank you very much for being interested in our Master of Communication Sciences, Digital Media and Society. My name is Stef Aupers, and I'm a professor in media culture and program director at the Department of Communication Sciences at KU Leuven. What I will do in the coming minutes is guide you through our program. So I will tell you something about the content, the courses, the goals, and obviously I will also go into the question, what kind of jobs can you apply for if you finished this program? So, first of all, the question is, what is this program actually about? The Master of Communication Sciences, Digital Media and Society is a one-year international master's program. And it focuses on the way digital media shape the societal domains of, first of all, personal identity and well-being. So the basic assumption is that we're all day long increasingly are exposed to social media, images on social media, messages on Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, etc., etc. And the question is very much, what implications does that have on the way we think, our feelings, and our attitudes and the way we act? So take the example of body image. What effect does it have for young adults to be surrounded on Instagram, for instance, by pictures of beautiful peers? What effects does that have on our self-image, on our body image, on our level of security in a psychological sense? But we can also think, secondly, on the implications of digital media on culture and community. So we know that that social life, that is social capital, social networks and community is totally transformed by digital media. A lot of the time we're on WhatsApp, we're on social media, but also gaming is a good example. I mean, games, in games, young people develop, strengthen basically their contacts with their peers, but are also developing new contexts and strengthen social capital in that sense. So these are interesting developments that we're focusing on. Thirdly, the question is, what implications does digital media have on politics and policies? So politics is no longer simply televised, as it was, say, in the 60s and 70s. It is increasingly a battle, if we're talking about the elections, that is replaced to the digital domain. And we know that, for instance, fake news, trolls, spreading memes, etc., have quite an important influence on elections. So think about the elections in the US, in 2016, that was quite a hassle in terms of the digital influence. Fourthly, there's a large influence of digital media on business and marketing. So business and marketing are no longer, marketing is no longer about placing an advertisement or watching some clips on television. It has become digital in many ways. And one example, of course, is influencer marketing, say the YouTubers or vloggers that are sponsored by big companies, product placement basically, and communicate the worth and the value of particular commodities and products to a younger audience. So what is the implication of that? What are the effects of that? How does that basically work? These are some of the questions that we deal with. So for you as a student, it's obviously important to ask the question for yourself if you're the right student for the program. Are you fascinated by the way digital media shape various societal domains? Are you interested in theory and methods to study, empirically study digital media and communication? You want to develop evidence-based strategies, perhaps, for digital communication, and work in the fields of digital marketing strategy, research and innovation, or the creative industry? So if the question is, if the answer to these questions is basically yes, then you might be the perfect student for our program. So how's the program structured? We have different, you could say, different parts, different aspects, different dimensions in our program. And first of all, we have the theoretical courses where we discuss the main theoretical insights in digital media and its implication for individuals and society. So this is an overview of the courses: Introduction to Digitalization, Psychology of Social Media, Digital Marketing, Production and Consumption of Digital Media, and Human-Computer Interaction. So that gives you an oversight of what type of topics you might expect in our theoretical courses. But in addition to these theoretical courses, we have also more small-scaled interactive masterclasses. You as a student have to make a choice on the one hand between media and crisis, which is one of the masterclasses, and on the other hand, media and design or AI, artificial intelligence society. Next year, it will be AI society that you can choose in this respect. So these are small classes that are very interactive, where we have big discussions between students and their teachers to get more in-depth knowledge of these themes and topics. So finally, if we're talking about the structure of the program, there are theoretical courses, there are interactive masterclasses, but there are also, of course, methodological skills and research. The master program, it's an academic class, of course, so we're also not reproducing knowledge, discussing knowledge, but we're also are learning to do research ourselves. So two elements are important here. First of all, the course Research Design and Digital Methods, where you learn how to solve practical research problems by using online sources and digital tools. And of course, you have to write a master thesis where you basically bring together all the theoretical insights and your methodological knowledge and turn it into a research of your own. Another aspect of the program is that we have an internship of 6 weeks. So in intimate dialogue with the teachers, with some of the instructors, and some of the employers in and around Leuven, you'll find a place to work for 6 weeks in and around Leuven to put your theoretical knowledge into practice. And on the other hand, there are elective courses in the domain of digital competence, marketing, or international competences. So these are important elements in our program. So basically theory, masterclasses, methods, and an internship. The question then is, how is the program taught? The Digital Media and Society program, we guess, offers variation in topics and teaching methods. You participate actively in academic lectures, in group discussions, guest lectures by media professionals, etc., etc. And of course, you work under supervision independently and with your fellow students. We have a student symposium that has to be organized. There are research assignments and obviously a master thesis. In addition, you actively explore the digital media and communication field. You visit companies, you do an internship, and you have an optional extended master semester abroad. So these are some of the possibilities that we offer to our students. Hopefully then you have a very, very inspiring year. But obviously we also want to know a little bit more about what are the career options after the program. Well, the Digital Media and Society program prepares you for a career as an academic expert in digital media and communication. And so our students will apply for jobs in basically three domains. First of all, the creative industries. So you can think about digital content producer, copywriter, news editor, journalist, video producer, but also a second domain, research and innovation. As a researcher of digital media, you are capable to become a user experience consultant, human-centered design expert, policy advisor, academic researcher, etc., etc. And finally, another domain is communication strategy. And you can become an online marketeer, work as a digital communication manager, press officer, spokesperson, strategic planner, PR consultant, etc., etc. There are ample opportunities if you do this master program, Digital Media and Society. So hopefully in this little clip, you had a more profound insight in what we have to offer in terms of courses, in terms of goals, and in terms of job applications. If you have other questions, detailed information about the program, its admission requirements, and application procedures, you'll find online at the address you see here. But you can also send an email to me as the program director or the program coordinator, Daisy Prats. Thank you so much for your attention, and I wish you all the wisdom in the choices you have to make. Thanks a lot, and hope to see you in Leuven. Bye-bye.